Rob?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Rob's Rogues in the Batman Universe. And you can see that Wayne Manor is back, so we're back to the Batman Animated Series action figure reviews, and something happened. I have one of them that just swelled up to almost over 6 inches tall. Of course, we know this is the new line from DC Collectibles, the Batman Animated Series line, or in this case, as far as this figure goes, this is the first figure from the series. This is the new Batman Adventures. This is the redesign of the fourth and final season of the Batman Animated Series TV show that ended up doing some crossovers with the Superman Animated TV series. So, now, the first three seasons of the Batman Animated Series were kind of at a wrap. They had started the Superman Animated Series, and they kind of changed their animation style just a little bit. And with doing that, they thought, you know what, let's do one more season of Batman with this kind of new Animated Series style, and or tweaked it just a little bit, rather. And we came out with this version of the Animated Series. So they decided, well, we'll bring in the Tim Drake Robin, and we'll have Dick Grayson Robin grow up and become Nightwing. So there was a lot of cool things that they did with this series. I am an OG, original Batman Animated Series fan. I remember watching the primetime first episode of On Leather Wings on Fox, you know, at 8 o'clock when it came out, I believe in 92. I'm probably getting my information wrong here. I don't have it off the top of my head. But I saw every single episode when it came out. I have VCR tapes in a box somewhere of, you know, me just recording these wonderful episodes. And it was really kind of cool being in high school and kind of falling in love with an animated series Batman all over again, because the last one that I remember having was the Superpowers and the Super Friends and all that type of stuff. So being about a senior in high school when this came out, my girlfriend at the time was like, why are you watching Batman cartoons? Aren't you a little old for that? I'm like, oh, don't you understand? This is so cool. It's a new interpretation of Batman. It feels real and gritty and, you know, and dark, and kind of took its cues from the Tim Burton movies, and I don't know, just made the cartoon seem more real. It wasn't the, golly gee, Robin, let's go over here and look at this big giant circle thing. There was a real stories to it that Paul Dini and a plethora of other writers wrote. And if you've been watching Rob's Rogues long enough, you know what a big fan of the animated series I am. And as you can see, the Kenner Wayne Manor Batcave Command Center, that's always the backdrop for my animated series figures. And I've been dragging my feet with, you know, just work and life and all these other things with reviewing Maxwell's animated series figures that he sent me so graciously almost over a year ago now. I've had them, and we've seen two rounds of them so far here. So I'm kind of rambling a little bit, and somebody's probably saying, Rob, just get to this. But it's kind of cool that this new line of figures came out from DC Collectibles while I'm still going through the last little chunk of the figures from Maxwell, and plus my own collection that you've seen here. So this is really cool to be able to kind of compare, and then maybe one of the next videos that you'll see will be an old animated series figure. So enough rambling and all that aside, I apologize that the intro for this went on a little bit longer. There's been a lot of reviews for this guy already, so I'm kind of up on some things that are with this figure, and kind of know some things to kind of watch out for. So now that I've seen a couple of them, I can hopefully let you guys know what to pay attention to when you're picking these up. But again, this is from the final series of the animated series, the new Batman Adventures, which was always hard for me to remember exactly what it was called, because you always just want to call it Batman the Animated Series. So this is the first figure. There's not a lot to this box as far as, I mean, the artwork is really cool. It's from the final season of the animated series. So you can see Batman, Robin, and then Nightwing is kind of here in the back. It's the reverse on the other side. And after watching Olivia's review of this, when she got to this portion, looking at it in the store, you were kind of like, where are the other figures in the wave? There's no information here on the back, so it's kind of a waste of a card that, I mean, DC Collectibles that we just saw in the Damian review would have all the other figures that are in the wave and everything, but that information is inside of here, so at least for somebody kind of going through and maybe on the store shelves kind of wondering, well, what other figures are coming out, you really can't tell from the back of it. But I like the artwork. Not that you're going to be able to save it, because once you start peeling this tape off, unless you kind of cut here, you're going to start tearing parts of the box off. But as some people point out, there are no onion babies. So if you have an onion baby, I'm sorry, you can't play with this action figure. That is 0 to 3 onion babies. So if you have 3 or more onion babies, if you have like 4 onion babies, then they can play with it. But if you have 0 to 3, you can't. Or if your onion baby is 3. So that's kind of how they get you there. So thank you, Chapman Films. So what we'll do, we'll get Batman out of package. And there is a ton of stuff to go over with this Batman, and this is probably the most accessorized action figure from DC Collectibles that they have ever made. So it goes without saying, this review is probably going to be long, so grab a sandwich, probably 2 sandwiches, or maybe a large pizza. Grab yourself a couple cans of soda or pop, depending on what part of the country you're from, and we will get inside and look at this figure. I cannot wait. Being a Batman animated series action figure fan and lover of the show, this is a great day to have a 6-inch action figure. Rob, stop talking. Let's get inside.
Okay, I've got Batman out of the package, and as you can see, I'm holding on to him because he's leaning. It appears one leg is longer than the other. What? Now, I kind of noticed this in Olivia's review. When she, you know, was doing her review, obviously, and it looked like he was leaning in, and you could kind of see her monkey with it just a little bit. Now, he does come with a display stand. It just looks like maybe the leg got pegged too high. So that's 2 that I've seen like this as far as being my own figure, and now Olivia's now mine. So right away, I'm not going to be able to get him to stand unless I get him in some kind of pose. If I let go of him, he's obviously going to fall. So what I'm going to try and do here is get you a view of his leg. I'll probably bring him down to this front part of the base so you can see. Just something I kind of wanted to point out. It's not something you can really check. You can see how he's leaning right there. So, yeah, it's a bit of a disappointment. The figure is really cool. You're probably definitely going to need the display stand that he comes with anyway, because even though Olivia could get hers to stand on his own, even though it looked like he was leaning a little bit, I think they could have a potential to fall. Mine's going to fall unless I have him leaned up against something. So let me readjust the camera, and I'll be right back in just a second. All right, this is him leaning to the side here. Now you can't see my hand here, but you can see how straight this is here and how straight we are here. This is up on the one leg. So as you can see, see how it is? There, he looks like he's kind of leaned to the side. So if I go up on this leg, it is shorter than the other one, which is, it's a shame. That's 2 Batman that I've got from DC Collectibles with shorter legs. Now, there's supposed to be 27 points of articulation here, so I'm wondering, do I have something off somewhere? Since I have both hands used here to kind of prop him up, you can see he's leaning there. Let's get the camera raised back up. I know this isn't the fun review part of the figure. Kind of looking at his crotchular region here. I don't know if it's from the way it's painted, but if we were to draw a straight line from one side to the other over here, this leg looks like it's higher up into the socket. So I'm really kind of messing with the lights here. So can you see that? If you were to pause it and draw a straight line from one to the other, I've got it balanced on the one leg. It looks like this leg is seated up too high. Even where the shorts are, don't really kind of match. So I hope it's just in my figure. Again, if I knew that going into this, would I have bought this figure? Heck yeah, it's Batman the Animated Series. So again, it's something I'm not like, oh, that's crap, I'm calling DC Collectibles, I demand a new figure. No, I'm not saying that. I
paid $22 for the figure. I do expect both legs to be touching the ground perfectly. But, you know, I'm kind of splitting some hairs here. You're going to need the display stand anyway, unless you get him in some kind of pose. But two of the last Batmans that I have purchased have ironically been short in the one leg. So it's going to be a little awkward for this review. I'm going to have a hand on him. So let me reposition the camera again, and we will get into the rest of the review. Okay, after much playing with it, as you can see, it does in fact lean. I've got the camera centered and everything with the viewfinder, so this top of the review base that I have here, everything is straight, so I'm not doing any weird optical illusions with the camera. And so yeah, he is definitely leaning. Needless to say, I am disappointed. That's a pretty pretty sizable lean. If I just use one finger, I mean, he is standing, but if I turn him just a little bit, there, that is straight. It's hard to tell right from here. So I know if I get him in more of an open stance, that he can stand a little bit better. But as you can see, he still is leaning to one side. So using the armature that he comes with, I'll be able to probably get him to come around his waist to get him to look like he's standing a little bit more straighter. Again, this could be just my figure. It's going to be kind of hard to tell in package. So maybe just kind of take a mental note for yourself, like where the placement of the two screw peg holes is. All that being said, I love having him. It's great to be added to my Batman Animated Series collection. So I've kind of wasted enough time here talking about things being straight, not straight. So we're just going to go on with the review. Again, I absolutely love the figure. Just, I wouldn't say a minor hiccup, but just a little something that's off for me. But anyway, from here on out, it's nothing but love for this Batman figure. Again, this is from the final season of the Batman animated series, the new Batman Adventures, as it were, instead of the new Adventures of Batman, which was a 1977 cartoon series featuring Adam West and Burt Ward voicing those roles. So, the look on his face, this guy looks like he just hopped right out of the animated series. What it really reminds me of, for anybody that had the PlayStation 2, and I think it was on Xbox as well, Batman Vengeance animated series, or the new Batman Adventures. Boy, I can never get that right. This is what it really reminds me of, is the way the animation looked in that video game. Again, it does look very much like the cartoon series, but I think it's really close to the video game, more so seeing it in a real 3D product right here. The bat is nicely sculpted here. I think I have a really good sculpted bat, no paint smudges or anything like that. A very nicely painted Batman, as it were. They captured the essence of the face very well. I didn't point it out, the sculptor on this is Irene Matar. Sorry if I'm saying your name there wrong, Irene. So I believe she did a really good job on sculpting this. But again, looks like he came right out of the animated series and the video game as well. So nicely done. And I like the blockiness of the head, how it kind of connects back there. It's supposed to be one seamless piece, but so you can get the head to move, they had to, you know, obviously put the cut there. So since we're talking about heads and cuts and the way things move and the way things stand, let's get into the articulation. The head isn't probably really supposed to move backwards and forward. It's due to get the cape off, which I'll show in a little bit. You have to take the head off to put the other cape over top, which I thought was kind of a clever way to have the interchangeable capes. So here's one cape that gives you a little bit more range of motion. It's just a rubber piece of cape, like a rubber piece of cape, rubber piece of plastic. But the head does turn left and right. depending how you have it pegged or how loosely you have it pegged, you could get him to articulate a little bit, but it's not meant to articulate, but you can kind of cheat there. The arms do go all the way around, full 360, does not get in the way of the cape. This side does a little bit, but you kind of have to move the cape out of the way. Sorry if I had that off frame there. The arms do not go up very far. That is about it as far as arms go. So I would have expected them to go up a little bit higher, but if you go back to the 98 and 92 figures, they didn't move up at all. They only went around. So, hey, I will take what I can get from the animated series. He does turn at the elbow here, or kind of the elbow bicep, but bends at the elbow. Turns at the wrist, and the wrists do come off with the interchangeable hands. He has a bend at the wrist. My belt looks a little crooked too. He does turn at the waist, not at the upper waist, but he turns at the bottom. So there you go. So I could probably wiggle this rubber piece around and get it to go into position. If you look before, the front part of the belt was kind of over here, so just by moving it a little bit, I do get it to turn. So, kind of hindered a little bit by the belt, and you see I kind of got the belt a little crooked again, so. But yes, he can turn. So that's nice that the belt is a rubber piece, and it is sculpted all the way around. Probably really had that off frame, I apologize. Let me back out of this a little bit so you can see a little more. Some people were kind of disappointed at the pegs right here. In the production footage that we saw, or the prototype images, these were not there. They were kind of covered up, or and we knew they were going to pivot here, but probably going into production, they realized they were going to have to do this. It doesn't bother me. Yes, it would have been nice to not see those there. They're in the back as well, but that's cool. And this is the first DC Collectibles figure that can do a complete set of splits. So like Olivia mentioned in her review, if DC Collectibles can get all their articulation figured out and how they want to do stuff, we could have some really good articulated figures. Legs go forward. So if there is a Batmobile, wouldn't that be cool for this line? He could sit in it very well, or a Batcave Command Center, because he can bend at the knee. So he can get in a seated position. It looks a little funny, but could do it. The legs won't go all the way up due to the belt getting in the way. They do go back, surprisingly pretty good, so you could do a kicking motion to the back. And there is, I was wrong there, there is boot articulation here, so that will swivel around that way. A hinge foot, and what a rocker. So DC Collectibles is doing some really cool stuff. Now, I have seen some people that have broken the foot off at the rocker. This foot here will pivot, but the rocker is really tight. So that's one thing I can say about these figures. They were tight. All the joints, so I really kind of move things around. So initially I thought, well, maybe he's leaning because I have a joint that's still kind of frozen, but I do think it's due to the legs. Somebody had pointed out from the Rogue show that, well, maybe my rocker is off. my rocker's off a little bit, but as you can kind of see here, that should be straight. So, I mean, that's a sizable gap right there. But anyway, I'm not going to dwell on it. I still really like the figure. So if I can get this guy to stand, which is the other thing. We got one leg longer than the other. Come on, stand, buddy. You going to stand? Okay, he's kind of leaning. You can see he's definitely leaning there, so that really kind of disappoints me a little bit. Trying to get over it. He comes with a lot of accessories, so let me cut the footage and I'll show you the accessories that he comes with. How is that for accessories? This is the most accessories we've ever received with a DC Collectibles figure of any type. We have 2, 4, 6, 7 hands, so you would have thought that we would have got well, three sets of hands, basically. So many different hands to do different things that you might want them to do. Some open, some closed to hold different things. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 accessories right here. 8 being the cape. 9 being some loose accessories, being the grapnel gun. And a batarang. So really kind of cool. I won't do all the accessories. I'll kind of show them to you. I'll get them out of the package. And then if you count another accessory being the base and stand. So kudos to Mattel. I bought some Mattel. I did say Mattel. Kudos to DC Collectibles for making a figure that comes with this much. And back to the way of having stands. And I think this line's going to need them just due to the way their body proportions are. So I don't know if I would entirely trust them on a shelf or a base, being that they could be kind of top heavy on one side. So we'll be right back in just a second. All right, now that I got everything out and all the accessories, if you were like wondering, gee, I wonder what other figures are coming in this wave, you get this little tiny poster here showing you the animated series and the new Batman Adventures. So they're not necessarily doing the animated series first, running all those characters, and then doing the new Batman Adventures. They're intermixing, going back and forth, so it's nice that they're just treating this as one whole line. So it's interesting that the first figure is the new Batman Adventures as opposed to the animated series, but neither here nor there. So this little poster shows you the wave that is coming out. So I'm assuming everything that's color coordinated, and I'm taking this from Olivia because that's what she said. That's what she said. with the waves. So I believe the first wave is going to be Batman, Two-Face, and Mr. Freeze. And then it's the blue wave. The red wave is going to be Catwoman, the Joker. I'm definitely getting Robin, the Dick Grayson Robin. And I like that they have an episode reference to each of these figures. So this Batman is from episode Mean Season. So I'm kind of curious to go back to that. So they have accessories based on that episode. So basically Batman looks the same in all of them. But Two-Face, Sins of the Father, which is the Tim Drake origin there. Cold Comfort, I can't quite remember that, but this is a new Adventures. The Cat and the Claw, one of the first episodes of the Batman animated series, says part one, so the first appearance of Selina Kyle. Joker, The Last Laugh. Robin, Robin's Reckoning, so that's a famous episode there. On the Other Wings for Man-Bat. The blue, next blue wave is Poison Ivy, episode Chemistry. Killer Croc and Baby Doll, episode Loves a Croc. Tim Drake, Robin, Old Wounds. The Creeper, Beware the Creeper. And Harley Quinn, The Man Who Killed Batman. So they will have accessories based on those episodes that were kind of key to those episodes. Is that making any sense? I'm rambling here. So I'm noticing light is running low on my camera again. I have so much footage on here. So I will show you the rest of the accessories, and we'll be right back in just a second. All right, again, I apologize for the lengthy review. There's just so much to go over here, and I did have an unforeseen little issue with my figure. But he does come with the display stand, which I think I will definitely be posing just due to how my figure is. There is a flat piece, I don't know if you can see this here, kind of a notch. This is going to be the back portion. You probably can't see that very well, but there's a little notch so you can kind of know how this pegs in there. So it's just a clear piece, and then you have kind of like the armature that will go around your figure to hold it. And it's, you know, pretty stiff here. I was worried that there was no like locking screw or something, so you can get it about at any height. So if you wanted to have an old animated series figure in here, you could. This is the, you know, the turnaround that you can see the different front view, side view, and back view of Batman. The cape, I think, is a tad bit too tiny, or a little bit too small, not too tiny, but it's a little bit small due to looking at the animation. It looks like it hits him at the ankle. This particular cape on both of them, I guess it kind of does. I thought it might go a little bit farther down, but with it billowing out, it does give the appearance of being a little bit smaller. So maybe I'm being a little bit nitpicky there, but anyway. So, on to the other accessories here, putting back in the tiny Wayne Manor. Again, we have the cape. This is the one that I'm going to probably be putting him with. This other cape, I don't mind it, but I just like the draped over the shoulder look for Batman. It does come with all of these hands. So I've got the tape here kind of holding them. So we have the grapnel gun hand here. And the grapnel gun kind of comes off here, so if you wanted to maybe attach a rope or something, I don't know how you would. But you can peg it in just a little bit so you can see a little bit of the grapnel gun, or you can have it in, you know, a little bit more. But that's kind of set up for him to kind of hold it, which I might have him do this one because he does come with a grapnel gun. So you have two grapnel guns. And again, this one comes off too. You can peg it in that way. I'm sure one of these hands, he'll be able to hold it. It does come with one Batarang. So I thought it was kind of odd that he only gets one Batarang, but two grapnels, one affixed to a hand and one not. So I would have thought that, well, maybe they would have had a hand that just had an affixed Batarang, but it does not. So, but again, it's kind of cool. I thought they would have at least given you maybe one more Batarang, but look how many other things we have here. And then just different hands. So, I mean, you could have him hold the grapnel, although, see, there's no open slot. I'm doing it off camera there, sorry. There's really no open slot to get that in, because you see how this one is. I don't think there's a hand that's like that to hold. But a fun problem to have. Or he could just be, you know, holding it. So he definitely can hold his weapons rather well. So I watched Olivia's review. And she had a little cup of hot water. Now, I don't have the hot water next to me. I may have to pause the camera again. But the head should, after watching her review, should come off. The peg is at the bottom. Yeah, mine came right out. So I didn't have any problems there. There's the head. The peg is at the bottom as opposed to the peg sticking out the top. And this just comes right off. And then the other one will just drape right on over. I think that looks really cool. So then this should peg right back in. Oh yeah, that is definitely the cape I'm gonna want for Batman. So the head does move a little bit. There we go, I just didn't have it pegged in all the way. But very cool, the head still moves. Awesome sauce. So being that my Batman's a little, you know, leaning a little bit, this stand is going to come in handy. So kind of spread it out a little bit. I probably drape the cape over the back. And voila, I've got Batman standing. So you can kind of tell here. There is the foot kind of gliding. So you can see how I've got one foot down and the other one flat. So he's on his stand. He's standing just fine. I'm not going to lose any sleep over it. Just something you might kind of want to watch out for. So I'm really, really happy with this figure. I have so many things to move here and get off. We will take, let's see, the grapnel hand here. And just pops right on and off. You can see that. So it now moves, bends, and attaches. So the hands can easily be interchanged. And I was hoping I got that in the right hand. let's see. I need a right hand. Right hand. There we go. For the Batarang to fit nicely into that hand. So we'll take off this hand. So just kind of twists. And the stand just came off. I just dropped it. I just dropped the stand there that he was on. But really cool. So you could get him, if I can get this to move right. This might not be the best cape for it, for this particular pose, but you can get him in a pretty cool pose. So, again, kind of playing with a little bit, that rocker isn't one to work on that leg, but there you go. I can get him to stand. So how cool is that? A very cool figure. So I guess depending on how I want him to pose, I may not even really notice the leg, but, you know, I'll know that it's still a little short. Sad face. Anyway, let's see some comparisons to his 1998 counterpart and kind of see what's the same and what's different. We'll be right back. All right, there we are. I don't know what is with my Batman figures, but they don't want to stand. This one is actually from Maxwell. It was in the collection that he gave me. As far as animated series figures that I reviewed, this was one of the most recent in that particular set. So this is his figure. So I think I pointed out in that review that his foot was a little warped, so I haven't done the hot water thing to put this back into place. But mine has the cloth cape on it. Now, this particular line originally did not come with cloth capes. This was like in the Gotham Tech Crime Solver series where they had the cloth cape. So I could very easily take this cloth cape off and put on this Batman's cape. And we would have, you know, the correct representation. And this Batman does stand. So as I'm saying that. But yeah, there they are. So very, obviously very similar. And seeing that this is a 1998 figure, as I'm trying to get him put here, the two figures aren't all that different from each other. Obviously, the size of the figures is definitely different. But you can see aesthetically, not much has changed. They really captured that. Of course, the sculpting is going to be a little bit better as far as how they make things and tool things, but it's nice to have a companion piece. And who would have thought 20 some odd years later I would be back to doing 2014 releases of the Batman animated series. The animated series just had its 22nd anniversary, if I'm doing my math right. Maybe 21, I might be off by a year or two, but 20 years later, and here we are again doing a Batman animated series figure reviews. So very, very cool. Here's a quick shot of some DC collectibles and a Mattel Batman to give you a different size scale. We see the proper DC collectibles Batman back here, a Mattel Batman, DC Collectibles, Greg Capullo Batman, and of course the animated series. So you can kind of see these are supposed to be in the 6-inch scale, so they're really close to 6. The Capullo series and the DCU proper line is 7-inch, and then the DCUC is about a 5-inch figure. So pretty close to the animated series figure. Due to the camera placement in this Batman, he is up in front of frame a little bit, but if I had him a little bit farther back, if I can do this here, you can see he is just a little bit taller, just a little bit, if you take the ears off a little bit off this Batman. So I kind of wanted to be able to show you that just as far as size, if you kind of want him to put this Batman with different figures for, you know, whatever reason you might want to. Final thoughts on this figure. I am almost 100% satisfied. Yeah, I do have a leg that appears to be a little bit shorter than the other. I've been messing with the knees and the hip sockets and different things to kind of see if maybe something isn't a little off somewhere. But for the most part, this figure is going to go on my shelf on his display stand and be proudly standing next to other DC Batman animated series figures. I'm not planning on getting the whole line. I was kind of talking to some of the Rogue Show members, and Olivia was kind of surprised that she's like, I would have thought you of all people would definitely be getting this whole entire set. I want to, but, you know, I have a big set of these that I'm slowly trying to complete. I'm getting really close, and thanks to the help of Maxwell, my animated series original figures are almost complete. It's just a big pill to swallow with the amount of figures that I would still like to buy. from Arkham Origins and just the normal, or not Origins, excuse me, Arkham Knight figures and other video games, and I play drums, so I have that upkeep, and the normal DC collectibles line, and next year is Robin's 75th anniversary, so I can only imagine the amount of stuff that's going to be coming out for that. So I would love to have every one of these figures, being such a big animated series fan, but I think I'm just going to get the figures that mean a lot to me, that were my favorites. So it might be kind of a hodgepodge group of figures. Initially, I was telling myself all I want are the Robins, and you know, maybe Nightwing if they do them. I would probably get the Bat Family. And I like this era of the Batman animated series. Granted, we have not received this Batman yet from this DC Collectibles line, the actual proper Batman animated series figure. I'm imagining at some point we will get him, but I'm not going to double up. I have this Batman. This is actually my favorite from the animated series, so that's the one I'm going to go with. But I might pick up a few of them here or there, or if I find some cheap, maybe I will. But as far as completing the whole entire line, I don't think I'm going to. It's just more of a money thing, and there's other things that I would kind of rather spend my money on, and being that it's going to be a big year next year for Robin, I think I really want to try and get as much Robin stuff as I can, being that I am primarily a Robin fan. So, anyway, today we've been taking a look at the DC Collectibles Batman Animated Series line in the form of the new Batman Adventures. This is figure number one, the 1998 version of the Batman Animated Series, the new Batman Adventures, Batman. So, as always, this is Rob for Rob's Rogues and the Batman Universe signing off, saying we will see you guys next time. Hmm.